Some workers on the low end of the pay scale in Wisconsin got a boost in wages today.
That's because the minimum wage jumped 70 cents an hour. That's more than 10% from $6.55 to $7.25. Now, while higher wages are good for the workers who keep their jobs, some small businesses are feeling some financial pain because of higher payroll costs. Fox 11's Mark Leland takes a look at both sides of the minimum wage debate.
It's payday in Wisconsin. Some 300,000 workers will see more in their checks.
Every little bit helps because I'm on my own now, and 25 cents here and there, it's a big help.
For Brianna Brooks, her $7 an hour salary at Zesty's Custard Shop in Alloway automatically increases to the federal minimum of $7.25. But her boss says Brooks and others will likely get more just to be fair.
It's about a 10% increase across the board because you have to do it, you have to be fair to everybody else and increase everybody accordingly.
Ted Zeman co-owns Zesty's and says the price of higher wages will have to be passed on to what he hopes are understanding customers.
We're going to have to do a little increasing in pricing to cover that, to help absorb it.
There are no plans to raise prices here at Austin's Market in Alloway. The manager tells me instead he'll be forced to cut hours and benefits for some of its younger teenage workers in order to make up the added payroll costs.
I see a lot of other factors involved here that go way beyond what the minimum wage is.
Jim Golubeski works for the Bay Area Workforce Development Board. He says those working minimum wage jobs are today's working poor and need more money to try and get ahead. He acknowledges some businesses will cut jobs and hours to save money, but he also points out raising the minimum wage can work to boost business.
I mean, minimum wage workers are doing one thing. They're spending their paycheck. That puts money back into the system.
I think that there should be an increase every year and a smaller one so that businesses like us can absorb it a little bit better.
The lowest paid workers wouldn't mind that as they continue to try and get ahead. In Alloway, Mark Leland, Fox 11 News.
13 states plus the District of Columbia have a minimum wage in their areas that are higher than the federal rate. For example, Michigan's minimum is $7.40. Illinois is $8. The highest of all is Washington State at $8.55.